The Supreme Court says that Bayer can't escape liability for the people injured by Roundup. Now, this, first of all, to begin with, this is a company, this is Monsanto, that was sold to Bayer.
Right.
Whoever the numbnut was who bought this company. I mean, I hope that person's been fired and that they never worked with a corporation again. They were advised, Bayer was advised to go in and buy Roundup. That was after three major lawsuits had determined that A, the folks, the Monsanto, had been lying and phonying up rat studies. They knew that the product would cause non-Hodgkin's lymphoma.
Right.
The information was overwhelming. And some CEO says, hey, looks like a good idea. We'll go buy this company.
Right.
Take it from there.
Well, I think it had to be the attorneys that are representing them, the defending attorneys, because this is a strategy here. They keep losing. $25 million case in California. They try to go to the Supreme Court. Supreme Court says we're not going to listen to it. But this isn't the first time they've tried to take a settlement all the way up to the Supreme Court,
right,
is it, Mike?
Let me give a shout out for Biden on this. Biden got in the way of them doing this.
Right.
He actually had his attorney general do something real significant, which is go before the Supreme Court and say, you know, you should not accept this review. We have all the information we need to understand. This is bad, bad stuff. We know glyphosate is killing people all over the world. And I'm going to send my attorney general to say this is a bad idea. Now, Trump, just the opposite. Trump said, no, you need to hear this. We need to protect Monsanto. We need to protect Bayer. Now, listen, WHO had come out in 10 years ago now, came out and said, this is bad stuff that's killing people all over the world in third world countries, because we were telling the world, hey, without Roundup, without glyphosate, we're going to have a food shortage. WHO came out and said, that's a lie.
Well, but our EPA approved it.
Yeah.
And that's what's used in the cases against your firm, against all the firms that are representing the victims of this. That's what's used against them. The other thing that we found, and I started looking at this story for a while ago, you got the state of Mississippi, they actually recommend Roundup to kill all the weeds as before you prepare for the crop.
There's a reason for it. When I took depositions in this case.
I
took five major depositions before the first one went to trial. And what we saw was that they're masters of putting their people in important political positions. Matter of fact, they were so good at it that they had three people that were basically running the EPA. They had people in the White House that had come up through the ranks and now were advising Trump about this and that, dealing with the product. They were masters of doing that all the way down to the state level. So it doesn't surprise me. It wasn't just Mississippi that did that, by the way. There's about 14 states that jumped on the Monsanto bandwagon and said, hey, this is a great idea. All the information showed that this company knew 50 years before they were selling it, that it was killing rats and they understood the science. It was non-Hodgkin's lymphoma.
Right.
They phonied it up, they covered it up, and here's where it really gets ugly. The EPA knew it, and they bought into it anyway.
Well, and they have settled. There's been a 11.6 billion dollar settlement.
Yeah,
but
yeah.
They didn't decide about the future cases, and that's what's biting them in the butt.
The future cases are going to be a disaster because it's a slow process.
Right.
It's a latent cancer, non-Hodgkin's lymphoma. You may be exposed year one and may not have any symptoms for 5 or 6 years beyond that.
Right.
So that's what they need to be worried about. It. They shouldn't put the product on. The people who did it should be prosecuted.
Right.
They should be perp walked. And unfortunately, we don't do that to people that are dressed up in suits.